Hello everyone, Machine Gun Joe here, and we are doing the Doom 3 walkthrough. And look at that, a Hell Knight all the way down there. So easy to kill. See? One entire clip. That's what it takes, is one entire clip. And that could be a chain gun, the plasma rifle, your machine gun, I believe. I'm trying to think what else. Yeah, like just one of those guns. It'll take one clip. Anyway, that's gross. So this is called Site 3. Site 3. That's the name of this level. Look at me just, like, take the hits. Shoot it in the brain! In the brain! Something else spawned. I heard it. Of course, it's a cacodemon. I'm gonna shoot it in the brain again. God, the shotgun sucks at long range. Anyway. Let's get some health. Wouldn't that be great if we could just administer health that way? Anyway, another Hell Knight. So I missed a little bit, so it's gonna take a little bit more. Let's see how much more. Ooh, this is more than I thought. Okay, so probably a little bit more than one clip with the machine gun, but not much more. And I'm sure if you shoot the clip straight in the head. Okay, we don't have the PDA for that, so let's go to the garage. Oh, wow. A maggot. I haven't seen a maggot in a super long time. So I do want to back up into this door, have everything come in through here. Oh, shit, there's something behind me. Fucking imp. I can't believe that cacodemon made it through this little hallway. So it's a great funnel point to funnel, like, the enemies through there. Of course, we would get destroyed if this was on a harder difficulty. So yes, if you wait about 60 seconds after you initially get in here, a Hell Knight will spawn. So be wary. Be ready for that. And Betruger laughing his sick ass off. And Archvile, we don't have the Soul Cube charged, so we're kind of... Okay, we made it through there. And it seems the Archvile is spawning two imps, which is just fine up against this plasma rifle, so we're good. Look at these candles are floating. It's interesting. Health! I don't see these candles in ascending and descending order like the instructions said in the email we read a couple levels ago. That's perhaps why they were unsuccessful with their invasion into Earth, maybe. I'm just saying, follow your own protocols. Now that is the sound of Revenant. Rawr, rawr, rawr. Rawr. Ooh. God, I don't have the run toggled. I'm moving so slow. Again, not super concerned with health because we have a soul cube, so which replenishes our health 100%. So this place looks interesting. Now, those little wavy lines, those are like orbital patterns right there.
This is the scientific journal of Dr. Richard Davis, dated August 8, 2145. We've just broken through to a new chamber, and I think I found the map alluded to on one of the tablets. The artifact is constructed into the ceiling, and it is a magnificent find. It appears to be made of some crystalline material, and even after all this time, it is still emitting a soft light. The markings on it were strange. And after digitizing it and analyzing it, I'm certain this is a map of our solar system. It seems to show a connection between Mars and Earth. My current working theory is that the last survivors used the teleportation technology to escape to Earth. The ramifications of this are overwhelming. This may end up proving that we are actually descendants of this race, and what we are exploring is our own history. I'm going to report my findings as soon as we finish the excavation, and they should show up in corporate within a few days. These are truly exciting times. Log out.
Exciting times, no doubt. More than he knows. Okay, what was that? Oh, shit, I remember this. God, these little platforms. I don't remember the explosions, though, however. I don't know what the fuck that was. That's very interesting. Four tablets up against some goo.
Placed in a holy burial ground of some sort, utilizing the best minds in linguistics.
God, the Hell Knight's reach is surprisingly long. Like, it can seem like you're out of reach, but if it seems like you're just out of reach, he will fucking hit you. Like, he has a little bit of a stretch going on. Now, if you notice the tablet on the very left there, that's the portrait, the cover drawing of the original Doom. So that's really interesting. They cut it up and they added a soul cube, but...
Are you sure you killed them? What? You have the soul cube, just like in the carvings I've been researching. If I'm correct, that cube is our only chance to stop this. No time to explain now. You need to get to the caverns quickly. Take my PDA. It's right there on the desk. It's got security codes for the area and my research logs on it. It'll help. I can't go with you. I need to finish my work here. Good luck. I'm locking the door after you leave. Good luck. I'm so close to discovering everything, I can't leave.
Yeah, whatever, buddy. The tablets are the key. I firmly believe your work with the tablets are the key to solving the mysterious relationship between the Soul Cube, the Ancients, and us. I am sending word to the Executive Council for an immediate increase. Blah, blah, blah. The structural integrity of the ruins is deteriorating. Sorry, I should probably put on my glasses. As you already know, expensive underground digs of this nature are an engineering nightmare. Yeah! Especially with all of the demons. running around. Just recently, one of our engineers, Peter, got crushed. I like how they, heh, stones, alive, spooky. I think we all need a long vacation. Dude, don't be so coy about people dying and getting crushed. Ugh, God, if I was ever working with people with such, like, ridiculous attitudes with work, I'd immediately call HR and ask for a transfer, as some of these people have done that we've read in the emails. God. Yeah, so Malcolm Betruger. Oh, those emails. Fuck that. This kind of results for the ceiling. But ceiling, that word looks weird right there, doesn't it? It's interesting. I can barely comprehend how immense this is. Mom says you're going to get to see you next month. I'll bet you that doesn't happen. Thanks for sending me the video games for my birthday. Have you tried Quake 43? Yeah, so obviously the people who have made this game make the game series Quake, which is like a Doom clone, which is a phrase no one uses anymore, but it's a first-person shooter. Anyway, I don't play the Quake series at all. So, at any rate, Betruger is mad, and things have gone worse than you could possibly imagine. Now your banishment from Mars has become a blessing in disguise. It has likely saved your life. You must get the word out. The answer to the soul. The answer is the Soul Cube object. It always has been. Listen to my report. I will upload my findings.
This is the audio log of Dr. Pierce Rogers. I don't know if I'll make it off the base alive. I don't have much time, so I'll sum up what I have quickly and upload the rest of my findings into the database.
Christ. I do hate it when you have multiple things being, like, you're listening to an audio log and then there's like another voice over. It's pretty annoying. Like, it just gives me a headache. And now you guys have to listen to my voice on top of that. It's like all these sounds going on that conflict with each other.
They created the Soul Cube and used it to stop the demons.
Okay, so that was the locked door. So now that we can go through that locked door now. So they're telling you this is the way to go because they have spawned an enemy there.
I can't reach.
So this locked door that we can now open.
I truly hope and pray someone finds the Soul Cube.
I think it takes 8 shots. 8 shots of the plasma rifle to kill an imp. You can tell by the sound. The poo 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 poo. Oh, we dodged those rockets quite nicely right there. That was good. That was really good. Didn't take a single hit. So this is the beginning. But we'll go left, finally. And go all the way to this locked door. This is where we weren't able to go. So now we can go here and take this elevator down. No, it's... Where the hell is he coming from? Yeah, there's an imp, though. I heard an imp. I still hear the imp. Where the fuck is the imp at? Is it over here? No. No. See? You can hear it. What the hell? All kinds of weird shit happening. Where the fuck is this imp? Oh! Oh, damn. Up there. Well played. Well played. Yeah, fuck it. We'll just go down here. What do we got going on in here? Okay. Armor, shells. Ghastly lit area. Okay, and you'll go to level 2, go to the maintenance level, which is up. This is that part, yeah. This is gross, like these little hallways where it's just basically like, ugh. It's disgusting. There's this one area, I swear, it's like reminiscent of like a colon, of like what colonoscopies look like. Bad colonoscopies, like one where they have like stage 4 going on. Anyway, let's go up these steps. This little hellish area. Oh shit! I was not expecting the cacodemon. But we're at 92% health, that's good. Another cacodemon. The cacodemons move like how balloons, I imagine, would move if you were to shoot them with like little air guns. Alright, so we also got some shells, got a clip. BFG! Yale! It's about time. And I think we have all of the weapons that we had before we went to hell. So. Cavern's entrance. Alright. So we're about 17 minutes in. The video is about 20 minutes long, so we're almost done. About 3 minutes left. Use the freight loader to gain access to the cavern's entrance. From here, you will go to Cavern Area 1 and Cavern Area 2. And then those two different levels will lead to the primary excavation site, which is the very last level. There's almost no enemies except for the final boss, just like in Doom 1. And it's letting you know you're headed, you have the right idea, you backtrack a little bit. Oh shit, what the hell? Ooh, I did not need to fall. Ew, this is like the colonoscopy one. Oh, it's so gross. Let's grab that health. But this is so gross. Blah, gross. It's so disgusting. And this is where that imp was trying to snipe us. So we'll go back, backtrack. Yay, we got health. Yeah, we don't need to do that. No, shouldn't have to come here. Yeah. Don't need to do that. Need to go this way. Go away from the elevator. I think it's... Yes, it's the garage, because we have to get into this yellow submarine looking thing. So let's make sure we grab everything that we need. Get on this little yellow bus here. Seal hatch. It's not letting me press it. I don't know what the hell. It's... Press. Ah, there we go. You had to get in. Get in all the way. And now it will allow you to go. So take a look. Just look at the soul cube for a minute. Those, like, it's like a bunch of eyes on there that are moving around. You know, it's a really interesting thing. It's not like a solid. It's like almost like a lucid not a lucid, but like a liquidy sort of, like a moving thing. It's like Play-Doh. So this is the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Followed along, you know, showing you the do's and the don'ts, mostly the don'ts. So I am Machine Gun Joe. This is the Doom 3 walkthrough. We are in Area 3, headed to Caverns, Area Number 1, and I will see you in that next video. So long. Good night, and good luck.